turnover. Now here's the action of the Penn State versus Pitt game.
It is 35 degrees. We may have some more drizzle today and maybe some snow as Franco kicks off to Collins at the Pitt 3. To the 22-yard line. A reminder that announcers on this telecast are contracted and paid for by Total Communication Systems. Any rebroadcast, reproduction, or other use of the accounts of this game without the express written consent of Total Communication Systems is prohibited. We move to further action with Penn State in control of the football.
Penn State!
Cole's in motion. Jackson, Kenny Jackson, first down at the Pitt 29-yard line.
Okay, big lead play. Here's Jackson. He goes down from his spot, curls in. There's an open area in there. Blackledge stepped up in the pocket against a lot of pressure. There's nobody around. It's a big first down for Penn State.
First down, hit 16-yard line.
Absolutely great pass protection, Ray. They fake. Watch the fake to the tailback one, and watch the pass protection. Blackledge has all day. Foul comes out, picks up his man. Jaggers does a great job on Boyoski, 68. Blackledge showing his great potential, rifles it over to number 80 Scoville for another first down.
The first down is at the Pitt 16-yard line. Jackson goes left. Warner moves to about the 13, where he's tackled by Hugh Green.
All right, come back. Penn State comes back with a draw play after completing two successive passes. Here comes Kurt Warner up to the inside. There's Fidel, comes across, holds his ground, and Hugh Green, dropping off from the end, again is involved in attack.
Second and seven at the 13. Two tight ends. Scoville on the left. Cab on the right. That was Williams, who just moved. Blackledge gets it to the 10. Incomplete. That was really thrown into a crowd.
Well, once again, he had great protection. That's really the first bad pass he's made. Just too much coverage over there. They got a double on Jackson. He's trying to run a corner pattern. Williamson's over there. Blackledge forces the ball. Probably could have run for the first down. Just a few too many people around there.
Herb Menhardt is 14 of 19 in field goal attempts. Hostetler, the holder, 27-yard attempt from the Pitt 17. 3:35 left, first quarter, and Penn State is on the board. Following the field goal by Penn State to give the Lions a 3-0 lead, Pitt has the ball. Number 34, Joe McCall. Mike Collins to the right, Willie Collier to the left. His leading receiver, Benji Pryor, the tight end, is on the right side. And behind the line, Gene Gladys nails McCall for a loss.
Ray, this is a titanic defensive game so far. Great defense. Watch Gladys, number 89. He comes on a blow, turns to the inside. He sees the ball carrier, fights off the blocker, and puts McCall down for a loss.
2-yard loss, second and 12. Now let's see if Pitt goes into the shotgun formation. Up, Tricano will be under center on second down 12. Collins. Matt Bradley makes the tackle, but the sparkling freshman receiver.
This is a great play. They had single coverage. Langford on Collins, number 12. They fake the McCall. Tricano steps up. Good protection. It's a post pattern. Here it comes from a different angle. Watch him right to left. They're great receiver. He has caught 10 touchdown passes. Cuts inside of Langford. Leaps high. Makes a great reception.
At the Penn State 46-yard line. First down, Pitt. Tricano, a lot of time. Leo Wisniewski drops Tricano for a loss.
Langford has been one-on-one on Collins all day. They try to come right back with the pass. They're not having success with the run. There's nobody to throw the ball to. Tricano decides to take off and run with it. He's a good runner. Wisniewski beats his block on the great All-Americans, 73 May, and puts him down for a loss.
Penn State leading 3-0 late first quarter. This is McCall. And Matt Bradley makes a great defensive play, number 86.
Great defensive football. Fake it, a dive to McMillan, number 40. He comes out, he's trying to run the option play with McCall, 34, as the trailback. D'Amico takes Tricano, he pitches it out to McCall, and Bradley nails him right dead in his tracks. Great defensive football.
Pitt goes to the shotgun. Here comes a rush. Fumble. Pitt gets it back, but short of a first down.
Nickel defense. Here they are in a shotgun. They're going to go to Benji Pryor. Now, there's a defensive back that's going to pick him up. He's number 84. He gets inside clean, gets hit, drops the football, but he's able to reach out, I believe, and recover it. Yeah, he gets that big one. Wait, still loose.
There's Bradley. Bradley. Willie Collier.
And Willie Collier recovered, number 4.
There was no further scoring. The quarter ended with the score. Penn State 3, Pitt nothing. We'll be back with second quarter action right after this. We're back with second quarter action with Pitt in control of the football. Collins to the left, Collier to the right. Pryor is split out to the left, the number one receiver for Pitt. McCall smothered.
It is a straight handoff to McCall, trying to pop it real quick. Case comes off the block real well and makes a tackle. Pitt only has two first downs, had two first downs in the first quarter, and Penn State only had three.
There was a gain of two as Case made that tackle at the Pitt 47. Second down, 8. Langford goes out with Collins, who is out to the left. Tricano, close to a first down. Penn State is leading 3-0. 12:29 left to play, first half. McCall, the tailback, and I believe he had forward progress enough for the first down, just inside the Penn State 45. Incidentally, number 37, Walker Ashley, is now playing at a defensive end. And Tricano is downed by Walker Ashley.
Penn State comes with the blitz. Watch number 73, the Outland Trophy winner, May, pass protect. Gets his man hit, went right by him. Number 76, Bergstrom, got off him and Ashley closed, but Tricano did a great job from stopping that from being a really big loss.
Collins again working against Langford. Tricano goes to a shotgun. Back 7 yards. A screen. Uh-oh. First down. McMillan all the way down to the Penn State 17-yard line.
Well, they caught him. It was a beautiful executed play. From the shotgun, he looks over to his right. The blitz come on the linebacker. Now there's McMillan. The screen sets up beautifully out here. Palavecchio almost got to him, takes it up the sidelines, and it tackles. A touchdown-saving tackle by Pete Harris, number 27.
At the Penn State 17-yard line, first down, Pitt. No wide receivers. Full house backfield. Tricano to the air. Touchdown. Benji Pryor.
basically, this is a simple play. Two tight ends and they cross them. They're in a power eye. Fakes off to McCall. This is Benji Pryor coming left to right. There's pretty good coverage. The ball's not well thrown. Benji Pryor leaps up, makes a sensational catch for the touchdown.
So Pitt has the lead with 10:35 to play in the first half, 6-3. The holder is Dan Daniels. The place kicker is Trout. And Pitt adds point number 7. Coming up at halftime, don't miss the Penn State Halftime Magazine featuring The Paternal Way, our flashback, the Penn State People feature, and the Penn State Action Journal. Following the Pitt touchdown, an extra point to give the Panthers a 7-3 lead. Penn State has the ball. Something happened. There was a mix-up in the backfield, and Ricky Jackson brings down Blackledge about a yard behind the line.
Well, Boyoski came across the line of scrimmage, got back without being called, and that distracted Blackledge. All right. Jackson makes the tackle. Watch. Number 68, Boyoski came back. Jackson comes in and makes the tackle. Blackledge got distracted and turned the wrong way.
There goes Coles. Wanted to hit Jackson, and it falls incomplete at the 15-yard line. It'll be fourth down. Menhart will be attempting a long field goal. About a 49-yarder with 4:58 remaining in the first half. Hostetler, the holder. It is wide, and Pitt has stopped Penn State following the missed field goal by Penn State. The scoreboard reads Pitt 7, Penn State 3, and Pitt has the ball. Second down, 8 at the Penn State 41. Down to the 20-yard line, Benji Pryor.
Well, that's the key man, Ray. I've said it before. Two tight ends is one-on-one. He just goes down about 12 or 14, breaks for the sidelines. There's good protection. Tricano puts the ball right on the money. It's a good catch. And then another big first down for Pitt.
So Pitt threatening at the Penn State 21-yard line with 2:37 left to play in the first half, and Pitt leading 7-3. Tricano breaking tackles. Gets about 6 yards to the 16-yard line, where Giuseppe Harris makes the tackle.
Basketball game.
Pitt has a first and goal at the Penn State 14-yard line. 46 seconds remaining in the half. Back to one tight end, Pryor. The interception. Pete Harris.
I tell you, if he saw the outside, he'd still be running. That's a great defensive play because if they... Let's watch Pete Harris, the free safety now. He's floating right in the middle of the screen. They're trying to hit Kaya coming, Collins coming across the middle. He picks it up. He decides to go inside. Had a little room to the outside. But however, he stops the pit drive.
The half ended with the score, Pitt 7, Penn State 3. We'll be back with the Penn State Halftime Magazine right after this. ...1975 brought one of the more memorable Pitt-Penn State games to a capacity crowd at Three Rivers Stadium in Pittsburgh. The fourth quarter began with Pitt leading 6-0 after a dazzling touchdown run by Elliott Walker. Carson Long's extra point conversion was then blocked by Penn State's Tom O'Dell. 8:40 left in the game, Steve Geis ran for Penn State's solo touchdown. Chris Barr put the icing on Penn State's lead with his conversion kick. Penn State 7, Pitt 6. Then Pitt drove 46 yards to the Penn State 34-yard line. The fun was only beginning. Carson Long missed not one. Not two. But three field goal attempts before the final gun sounded, with Penn State edging out Pitt 7-6 in what has to be one of the better thrillers in recent Pitt-Penn State matchups. We're back with the second half with Penn State in control of the football. Warner. Fumble. And Pitt has it. A great run by Warner. Tom Flynn recovers, and a big break for Pitt.
Well, here we got a sensational opening play for Penn State. To draw a play to Kurt Warner. Good blocking, gets good block from his fullback, turns it to the outside, makes a couple of great cuts, makes Flynn misses, heads for the sidelines, gets popped from behind by Ricky Jackson, fumbles the ball, and Flynn trailing recovers it for Pitt.
Great protection for Tricano. Wide open Dombrowski at the Penn State 22-yard line for a first down.
Well, here we got a three-man rush, and the three men do not put enough pressure on Tricano. You cannot let any quarterback sit back there all day, because the receivers will find openings in the zone. This is what happens. He finds Dombrowski downfield about 12 yards in an open area and makes the completion.
First down at the Penn State 23-yard line. Again, two tight ends. No gain. Good play. Matt Bradley came out of the secondary with help from Griffiths. Loss of a yard. Second down, 11 at the Penn State 23. This is McMillan. And Chet Parlavecchio makes a tackle after a gain of about 4 yards. At the Penn State 20-yard line.
Hey, that was a sensational. All right, watch Parlavecchio. They come down with a fullback option. He fills to the inside. Now, he's got to make the tackle on McMillan here, because he's got the pitch and he's turning upfield with a lot of daylight. Big play by Chet Parlavecchio.
Third and 7 at the Penn State 19.5-yard line. Pitt leading 7-3. Again, a big third down. DeBartola is the fullback. 1 yard to the 18. Dave Trout has been successful in 12 of 17 field goal attempts. This will be a 35-yard attempt. It is good.
Got it.
Penalty flag at the 25-yard line. Jackie Sherrill. Here's the call. Running into the kicker.
Let's take a look at it. It's a question whether it was late. The ball was snapped late and the timing was off. Now he does run into the kicker, but the question is, does the ball go through first? That's number 66.
Pitt kicked an apparent field goal. Rich D'Amico ran into the kicker, Trout. Result, no field goal. First and goal, Pitt, at the Penn State 9-yard line. That looked like the tailback, Joe McCall. Yep, number 34, the freshman from Miami. There's a virtually no gain. Second and goal, Pitt at the Penn State 9. This is Tricano being chased by D'Amico. Touchdown.
All right, some bootleg all the way. They fake the lead to McCall. Here he comes. Langford goes for the fake. And D'Amico gets caught to the inside. And now it's a foot race. Tricano has a little too much speed for him. Takes it in for a big touchdown.
So Pitt moves to a 13-3 lead. Dan Daniels, reserve quarterback, the holder for Trout. And all of a sudden, Penn State is down 14-3.
We move to action later in the third quarter.
He just beat the 25-second clock.
Intercepted, Ray!
That is Gene Gladys who intercepted.
Another opportunity for Penn State. Now, if they're a good football team, they must put points up on the board. That was Gene Gladys from a defensive end position. He dropped off to the weak side in the flat. Let's watch him, number 89, folks. He's on Dombrowski, slides off. He follows the football, stays in his zone, leaps high, makes a great interception. Tries to get upfield to get as much yardage as he can. And Penn State is in good scoring position.
This is Scoville at the 10.
Well, Ray, I was just saying they're playing so deep for the deep pass. They picked it up. It's a little fake of the... Let's watch it. Watch Billy Dugan block. Watch Scoville running right to left. Find that hole in the zone. Here it is. He's underneath. Here comes the ball. Big first down and a great catch by Brad Scoville.
The option play is smothered by sophomore tackle Phil Pozzoli, number 63. Penn State has a second down and 13 at the Pitt 13-yard line, 2:49 left third quarter.
Comes the rush. Touchdown.
Touchdown, Jackson.
Oh, did he drill that one? Well, Ray, you could not see a corner pattern run any better for a quarterback stay in the pocket and fire the football between two defenders. Now, let's take a look at it. Now, watch the coverage. Now, watch Jackson. That's double coverage on him.
Now, this is the touchdown,
this
right?
This is the touchdown. Scoville takes the flat to clear out. Jackson does a corner pattern. Now, watch this ball is drilled between two defenders right there. Watch Jackson. He takes it to the inside. That's Williamson, 48, bumps him, takes it to the outside. All right, White comes over his shoulder, and Williamson comes back to try to sandwich him, but the ball is too well thrown with too much authority. Now, what does Hugh Green do? What's Green do? He's going to put the rush on Billy Dugan. Takes his drop steps, gets him face up. He's in good position. Billy Dugan's in great position. But look how strong Green is. Good thing the official didn't see that.
Jackson in motion.
Oh!
Couldn't quite get the ball to Jackson.
Well, Ray, he caught the other one, and I'll say, if I had my choice, he dropped the right one.
There was no further scoring. The quarter ended with the score. Pitt 14, Penn State 9. We'll be back with fourth quarter action right after this. We're back with fourth quarter action with Penn State in control of the football.
Oh, beautiful play. I think it's 64. Well,
63.
63, but when he had his hands on the ball, he was still in the ball in the field of play, and that's what they...
And you know who made that play? The center who snapped the ball, Bill Rochelle. A big, big catch for Benji Pryor. Fumble? Or was the ball dead?
He was dead. However,
so Benji Pryor.
They go. Penn State goes to a three-man rush. Danny Marino, cool as a cucumber, stays right back in there, rifles it to Benji Pryor, who fought off the coverage right down in the center and makes a big, big, big first down for Pitt.
Look at that defense, or that protection. Going deep for Collins.
Intercepted.
Giuseppe Harris. Giuseppe Harris comes up with the third Penn State interception.
All right, Danny Marino, remember, he's only a sophomore. He wants to get the ball deep to Collins. The coverage is there. He has plenty of protection. There's just too much coverage. He throws it, and this is Giuseppe Harris from free safety coming over there to help out Grover Edwards, number 45, makes the big interception. There's a nice one, Collins. Just blinding speed. He's trying to outrun the coverage, but they got him double covered. That's Edwards there. Now watch Giuseppe coming, number 26, over left to right, making a great interception.
Coming up at the end of the game, the presentation of our player of the game. Our sponsors, Subaru, Daly's Juice Products, Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, St. Louis, brewers of Budweiser and Michelob Beers, and by Westinghouse. After Penn State's third interception of a Pitt pass, the teams have exchanged punts. Penn State has the ball. Blackledge on first down. Kevin Bow, first down.
Short, that a boy. Great pass.
At the Pitt 46-yard line.
Watch Kevin Bow right here on Thomas, who's a great back. Watch him come back to the football. The short stuff can work and makes a fine reception. Not bad for a freshman, keeps both feet in bounds.
Fake reverse, this is Coles. Coles gets about 3 yards to the Pitt 42-yard line. Warner gets to the 38-yard line where Penn State will have a third down and a little bit less than three. Booker Moore, very close. He'll be about a half a yard shy at the Pitt 36-yard line where Booker ran into Greg Meisner. Penn State has a fourth and less than one at the Pitt 36 and a half yard line. Warner. And Pitt holds. Was that the game? Game-saving play for Pitt, we'll see.
It looks like it was. They went to an option, they fired. I can't see what looked like the linebacker Sincero, 66, and Kurt Warner has no place to go.
After Penn State's offense stalled on fourth down, the Lion defense did not crack, force Pitt to punt. The Lions have the ball. First down at the Pitt 34-yard line. Blackledge has a first down.
They got 58 seconds. They have all the time in the world if they keep their cool now.
The clock starts to run. Intercepted by Williamson.
I don't believe that.
Blackledge never saw Williamson.
He's much too deliberate, Ray. He's trying to throw the ball out of bounds, and he's just too casual about it after playing a great game. Now watch, he's played a great game. He wants to throw it out of bounds. He's just too casual, and he doesn't throw it out of bounds far enough. He's trying to make a completion over here. Oh, what a tragic way to end the football game. because it was a great game by both teams.
Pitt ran out the clock, and the game ended with the score, Pitt 14, Penn State 9. We'll be back with our player of the game, our scouting report on Ohio State, and our player of the year presentation right after this. It's the Penn State Nittany Lions versus the Pitt Panthers, where the final score was Pitt 14, Penn State 9. George, have you ever seen a better defensive game?
Well, great. It was one of the greatest defensive games I've ever seen. Number four team in the country against the number five. I doubt if there were many teams in the country could have beaten either team out there today. It's a shame that Penn State had to lose it the way they did. The fans saw the game. You know, it's a veteran team against a young team, and usually the veteran team will find some way of winning, and the Pitt Panthers did that today.
So for Pitt, it's on to the Gator Bowl. For Penn State, it's on to the Fiesta Bowl. Those would be our thoughts on the Pitt game. Now to Coach Joe Paterno and his thinking about the Pitt contest.
Well, I thought it was a great football game. Pitt deserves an awful lot of credit. They hung in there tough, made the big plays when they had the short yardage play situation. And when we had field position early in the football game, we didn't capitalize on it. And against a team as good as Pitt, it's pretty tough to make long drives. At times we played very well. I thought our defense the second half just played a super football game, but as well as you can play. And overall, I was proud of our kids. I think they went in, came in here, they're trying to win the football game, and right up to the end, it was anybody's ball game. But it was a great game, and Pitt's a great football team, and I want to congratulate them.
Let's take a look at some of the outstanding plays in the game. Jackson. Kenny Jackson, fumble. On a keeper. Big rush. Big hit by Matt Bradley. Here comes